Okay, hopefully you guys should be able to hear us now. Please let us know if any of the audio is stuttering. I'm trying to get everything set up in a hurry for you guys so we can get the show on the road. The mic needs to be turned way down, though. Just try to let us know whether or not it's getting drowned out, though. That's the key. We still want you guys to be able to hear us, whoever's doing commentary. Okay, we just turned down the mic. If we get the word that the mic is at a good volume right now, then we are getting started. Just let us know. I'm just waiting for some seem goods in the chat. Seems goods in the chat. Alright, so it looks like we're on the road. Because I'm going to be commentating from here. So I know who's on which side. Can you make that so it stays on permanently? Or is that not a feature? That's fine. We'll ignore the score count. Is there a way to make it appear permanently, or is that just not gonna happen? That's okay if it's not. Okay, got it. I understand. All right. So I think we're going to go ahead and take the bracket, figure out who's getting started with this, and go ahead and get going. I'm gonna tell you guys a little bit about how we're gonna be doing this. The arcade stage 7 allows you to develop your own car using cards and get upgrades for your car. We're not going to be doing any of that. We're going to be using all stock cars, so everyone's on even playing field. I believe we are going to be using rubber banding, or no? Are we using rubber banding?
Yes.
We will be using rubber banding, so that should give players a little bit more of an equal playing field when it comes to the different cars that are chosen. I don't recall exactly how we're going to be deciding tracks and... I don't know exactly which way we're going to be choosing tracks and conditions, but we're going to try to do our best to make it fair for everyone.
Initial DQ.
Very clean.
Yep.
We're pretty excited about this. We've been planning this tournament since about a month before the GDQ. Konosumi did a lot of work to set all of this up. Lord Mouse did a lot of work to set this up. And probably more so than anyone else, Sir Stendek really worked hard to make this a really special event. So hopefully this stream is fun to watch, as much fun as it is for us to play it. And I'm going to do my best to try to provide you some commentary. I unfortunately don't read anime, so what's going on the screen is going to be a little hard for me to commentate always, but in general, I'm going to do my best for you. Yeah, the cabinets themselves actually have video out on them, which we were fortunate enough to be able to use thanks to Tokyo Attack. They really made all of this possible.
Alright, so who's going first?
Alright.
What?
Alright. So, when they get off the machines, we'll get started.
Yep.
Alright. So, the guest was nice enough to test things out for us right now, and when he gets off the machine, we're going to get started with this tournament. First up, we're going to have Naze and Meekin going face-to-face in round one. After that, we'll be having Pairstrike and Danny Player One. All right, so it looks like we're going to get started. Meekin's going to be hopping on the machine. This is actually backwards.
I know, this one's backwards, but it's supposed to be.
Is
right?
it?
Because...
Naze's on the left right now.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, that's Naze.
Yeah, well, that works then. Dude, right. That button is nice, right?
Yeah. All right, so it looks like we're pretty much good to go. Meekin's going to be hopping on. Yep. All right, so how are we picking horses?
Oh, I know. Good question. Random horses? Okay, so we need a random number of horses.
No, we just get one horse.
No, because we don't necessarily want all, like, rain, and we don't want the snow horses.
Yeah, I think we're going to stick with daytime and clearer conditions. For all of them, as far as uphill, downhill, that can also be randomized. It doesn't matter to me. So we'll coin flip for uphill, downhill, but we need a random number for what course we're going to get. I think that's just going to be the easiest and fairest way to do it, rather than counterpicking or anything. Yeah, just do random.org. Can you be in control of that, or do I need to pull up random.org on here? Yep, that's true. Okay. Yeah, if you pull up random, I can pull those out as well.
How many do we need for the courses? How many courses?
When they get to the track selection for the first time, we'll look at that. Okay. Go ahead and start up. All right, so our racers are going to go ahead and get started. And to start off with, they're going to pick their car. So pick whatever car you want. We're playing a lot of this by ear right this second, so bear with us while we do our first few matches and kind of work out exactly how we want to do this. Alright, so we're getting set up for our first match right now. Alright, so we're going to randomly draw from 16 different possible courses. I just went to sleep, probably. Oh, is it plugged in right now? Alright, so right in a second, I'm going to go ahead and... There you go. Alright, so we're going to draw from one of 16 different courses. Yeah. So it looks like our first match is actually going to end up being on the first course. Not exactly the most attractive course. Yep. We got game here. Should I send it to not the first course? All right, so our first match is getting started right here. Naze versus Meekin. Alright, so we're setting back up here. Right now we got Meekin with a little bit of a lead right here. Now, I know this isn't the most interesting track. We're doing the best we can, but in future rounds, we're just not going to pick this track. Naze just barely edging through Meekin. A lot of straightaways on this one, so it's all about just maintaining all that momentum. This track is definitely going to be decided in the corners. Now keep in mind that over the duration of this tournament, we are going to be leaving rubber banding on. So for a lot of these courses, if we have two pretty evenly matched competitors who are staying pretty close to each other, we're going to have a lot of trading off of who's in the lead. Like both competitors have chosen automatic transmission. Now I think you're probably going to see a lot of people preferring to choose a manual transmission car. It definitely comes in handy when it comes to some of the more difficult tracks like Arozaka, Makina, Akagi. I think in the end, though they weren't exactly anticipating playing this track, I think they both made the right choice choosing automatic transmission. Thank you all once again for tuning in for this. We really didn't expect this much support, so it's awesome. Alright, so that was a close race, but Naze just barely edged that out in the end. Probably won't be using this track again in the future. Just sort of worked out this way right now. But going forward, we probably won't end up using this track. This is, however, a double elimination tournament, and with that, we are going to end up with Meekin dropping into the loser's bracket. Oh, wait a second. I told it to report Naze as the winner, didn't I? All right, so next up we're going to be having... There we go. Next up we're going to be having Pear Strike and Danny Player 1. Pear Strike and Danny Player 1. No problem. With that, we'll be moving into our second match of round one. All right, both of our competitors are going to be picking their car, and in the meantime, we're going to be choosing our track. All right, looks like they're going ahead and picking their car right now. Yes, we are using all base cars for this tournament, just to avoid giving anyone an unfair advantage with having prepared a card in advance. With this, we're getting started with our second match. match, we've got Danny Player 1 with the Super RZ versus Parastrike with a Trueno. Oh, he's got the AE86. Started here. Danny takes an early lead right out the gate. Now looks like we've got Parastrike on automatic transmission while we've got Danny with manual transmission. Hopefully he's prepared for this. The automatic transmission is definitely going to help a lot. You can still downshift in this game with automatic transmission. But it'll take care of all the upshifting for you, which in some cases can be really useful, but you know, sometimes it's nice to be able to stay in the lower gear for a little bit longer to have better control of the track. This course is all about the turns. Parastrike is maintaining a pretty good lead, but keep in mind we do have rubber banding on, so Parastrike is going to be slowed down and Daniel will be sped up for as long as he finds. Straightaway, Danny has definitely gotten the opportunity to pick up some speed over Parastrike, well, certainly due to the rubber banding, so we're going to see whether or not Danny can overtake him in the series of turns coming up. Alright, with that, Parastrike is taking that win. He managed to keep a pretty consistent lead over Danny over the course of that race. Next up we've got Mildew and Nosley. It's written down here as Nosley.
Huh?
Nosley. Who's up next? Nosley. Oh, is it Noslu? It's Noslu something. All right, we're picking up our next race coming up pretty soon. this for just a moment. Started with our next race, Mildew versus Nozlu. Started now. Nozlu got started with a bit of a lead. They're both on manual transmission, which is nice to see. As the day goes on, I'm going to expect to see a lot more people on manual transmission. You get a lot more control, and in general, the competitors that go on to make it to the later rounds, I'm expecting that we'll probably be seeing a lot of people on manual transmission from now. So many people showing up for this. This is really exciting. 93 viewers is more than we could possibly ask for. Now, Mildew ended up overtaking with the Tirreno, but it looks like they're staying really close together. This is a really exciting race. And with the rubber banding in effect, these straightaways are definitely closing the lead. Oh, Mildew's working hard to box Nozlu out. He doesn't want him to get past. And in this game, you don't get penalized a whole lot for your car interacting with the other car. So there's really no penalty for spending a lot of time boxing your competitor out. The only side effect is that you can't really focus quite as well on driving if you spend so much of your attention on trying to make sure your opponent can't get by you. Nozlu's definitely going to be looking for one of these turns to overtake. That's going to be his one opportunity to get by Mildew here. It's easy to box out your opponent when you're on a straightaway, but in a turn, you're so focused on making sure you don't put yourself in the corner, that's the perfect opportunity for someone to skate by in an instance like this. Mildew's working really hard to box him out. If anyone in chat actually knows the names of all the tracks in order, it would be very helpful if someone could paste it in the chat. I know that might be asking a lot right now, but it would be helpful for us to be able to pass that information along to you. We built a little randomizer tool for picking a random track and condition, whether or not it's uphill or downhill. But it would be nice to be able to mention the tracks by name. So. great race. Mildew ends up taking over in the end. All right. Next up, we've got Toggle Switch versus Lightning. So much for whoever posted that link.
So we're switching mics really quick. Thank you so much, Banya, FGX, and Zither for the links. I'll actually be able to tell you guys which map they're actually racing, not just the number.
Exactly.
That we're on our way. Looks like we've got Toggle Switch with the Celadi, and we've got Lightning with the Lancer Evo. Early by trying to box out Toggle Switch, but Toggle Switch ends up skating by and Lightning overtakes him again. We've got both of our racers on automatic transmission right now. Quite a while boxing out Toggle Switch, but Toggle Switch ends up getting by and taking off. You are mine and feel and gain my love. now he has to hold it into this turn. The rubber banding is just swapped sides. And that can be very dangerous when you overtake right before a turn. Both players looking to slow down right before the turn. The rubber banding can have a huge impact, allowing you to take the lead right back right after losing it. Lightning's looking to find his opening on the inside, it looks like, and he takes it. Wonderful race. And with that, Lightning takes it. We are moving into round two, Konosumi versus Naze. We've already seen Naze here once. He ended up taking the win on Lake Akina. And Konosumi on Tsubaki Line. This is going to be downhill. All races today are going to be in clear conditions, daytime, to give everyone an equal footing. Versus the MRS. Jumping off the line, it looks like Konosumi's going to get an early lead, but Naze takes it right back. Yeah. taken, and they're entering a pretty long series of straightaways. So the question here is whether or not Coach Shumi is going to be able to box him out, and it looks like, oh, he's holding. The Nazi passes him at the last minute. One thing to keep in mind is in these long series of straightaways, the rubber banding effect really does start to take effect. Players behind are going to get a big speed advantage, which is going to help them overtake him when they get back to all the turns. That Konosumi took the lead right at the end. Next, we're going to have Ace of Spades versus Amory Lin. We're going to move past that match. Amy ended up having to drop. And with that, we've got Sir Stendek and Pear Strike. We're gonna skip that match for right now. Pear Strike's still around, but we gotta get our hands on him. So up next, we're gonna have Reign of Soten and Tim O'Ryan. Bear with us for just 1 second. Thank you.
right now and I can drop it later. Yeah. All right. Rain, you're gonna buy for right now.
On uphill. This will be beginning pretty soon. Both the FD and the Supra have a good amount of power, so the uphill is pretty suited for them. Alright, here we go, the battle's about to begin. Alright, we're off the starting line, and Otto has a slight advantage on the inside, on the first corner. Edging out the Supra. Oh, but things change when we get the corner. Alright, Arthur gaining a bit on the Supra and overtaking on the inside. Pretty close so far. Oh, and Mildew overtakes Arthur once more. But Arthur has a bit more acceleration at the straightaway. Entering Section 2, Ott has a pretty good lead on Mildew, but things can change at any moment here. Oh, Mildew. Mildew's gonna overtake Ott here in just a minute here. Oh, but Ott takes the lead back in that corner after an error from Mildew. With Arthur at the speed advantage out of the corner. This race is all over the place right now. Go either way. Oh, Mildew trying to get on the inside in that corner. Taking the inside on the straightaway, overtaking Arthur. Slowly edging away from the FD. And off, they're both on the straightaway, going into the hairpin. Mildew carried a bit more speed in that corner. Oh, but they both grind them off a little bit. But Arthur's able to pull ahead and overtake Mildew. Now we're entering the final section of the track. Author is in the lead with Mildew falling short behind. We go either way at the moment. Going into two consecutive hairpins, Mildew overtakes Author. Mildew carried a bit more speed in that corner, but we have another hairpin coming up. Mildew is quickly accelerating away from Author Blues, but we still have a bit more of the track left to go. Author getting a little bit on the Supra, with the finish coming up, and Mildew takes the win. Well done. And now I'll be handing back to Mike over to Oz. Thank you, guys.
All right, we've got Pear Strike and Stendek back in here. The next track we're going to have coming up is Hapakahara Inbounds. Time extend, we're into section two. Now, for anyone who's played this course downhill, you know that this is the segment with all the consecutive hairpin turns. For as difficult as this is downhill, this is equally as difficult uphill. It's a huge battle to maintain your speed through all of these turns. Downshifting, upshifting is necessary, but doing this uphill is even worse. You'll notice that Suspendex actually automatic transmission. I'm interested in knowing how much that's actually helping him through this. Parastrike's having a little bit of a challenge in manual, but he hasn't fallen too far behind. I think it's really just a matter of time before he's able to overtake. We're just about to enter Section 3. With that, we have two more sections left in this course. Parastrike's right on Sir Stendek. It's anyone's race at this point. With that, Parastrike just overtakes. Sir Stendek takes it back. This is still anyone's race. Parastrike has lost a little bit of ground, but it's only a matter of time. This is an incredible challenge to hold your speed through these turns. We're now entering Section 4. A final batch of hairpin turns, followed by a long straightaway into the end. Zendek has managed to capture quite a lead on Parastrike. With that, the race is coming down to straightaways. Zendek manages to have the speed advantage at this point, but Parastrike is trying his best. These two had to deal with an extremely difficult course for the cars that they chose. Unfortunately, we don't tell them their course before they pick their cars. And so Zendek wins it. And that's going to knock Parastrike down into the loser's bracket. That we're getting started with another match. This is going to be the Guest versus Irish Joker. Once again, we have another uphill course that's going to be quite a challenge. We have the Lancer Evo versus the S2000. Right off the start, Guest gets a little bit of a jump in section one. Guest taking these turns pretty wide, but I think that's probably for the best considering the situation. Irish Joker pushing ahead. But Guest is closing the gap. Irish doing his best to box out the Guest. But he overtakes him in the end. Both races coming up on the time extend for section one, heading into section two. Both racers taking the inside lane. The Guest boxing them out. Now, neither of them really has a speed advantage. At this point, it's anyone's game. Well, the Guest lost some speed. Irish Joker was able to easily overtake and is pushing ahead now. Coming up on our first hairpin turn. Irish Joker easily navigates. Guest is closing the gap thanks to the rubber banding. Guest still has a speed advantage, is able to easily slide through the corner. And like I said in the past, it's so easy to box out your competitor when you're on the straightaways, but navigating those through the turns can be incredibly complicated. Irish Joker pushing through. Guest is pushing hard. Neither has a speed advantage at this point, though Irish Joker keeps pulling ahead a little bit. I think the rubber banding is giving the Guest a little bit of an extra leg. Still one more section to go after this. The Guest wants through and he gets it. Now we begin our fourth and final section. A few easy turns. The Guest should have no trouble boxing out Irish Joker for this, but he's going to have quite a challenge when we come up on this turn. Can Irish Joker get through? No, but he has the speed advantage still. And what a speed advantage it is. And the overtake. Still anyone's race, the Guest now gets the speed advantage, pushing forward in sixth gear and automatic transmission. Both racers in their top gear. Iris has to block and box him out. And in the last minute, holds him off, puts him into the wall, and keeps the speed advantage for himself. Great race. Next race, we've got Hikage going up against Lightning. Right. right, for our next race, we're going to be on Coggy Downhill. Easy track for an experienced racer. Got both of our racers on automatic transmission. And for the first time so far today, we've seen one racer choosing to race in third person mode. An interesting choice. You actually get to see a lot more of your car and what's around you. But I think a lot of people do prefer the first person perspective for being able to control themselves through the turns. Kage doing his best to try to get by Lightning, but Lightning was holding them off until now. Both racers are entering section 2. Lightning has a little bit of an advantage right now. But Mikage has the speed advantage. Looking for it to pass through. This is a pretty wide course, so Lightning has to work pretty hard to box them out. Kage was doing his best to try to box Lightning out, keep him from overtaking, but wasn't able to hold him off. And now we are entering a series of hairpin turns. Wide lanes make it very difficult for racers to keep their opponents from overtaking. Looked like Kage was going to overtake in that previous turn, but he waits till the next one. With a speed advantage, he easily pulls away. We're partway through Section 3, quickly coming up on the time extend for Section 4. It's the end of the race, anyone's shot. Kage loses the speed advantage, this is going to be tough. Lightning is poised well to overtake easily, and at this point, it's just a dash to the finish. Out, the race is over. Lightning winning over Kage with a 30-meter lead. show. All right, we're going to be going up with the guest versus Danny Player One. This will be one of our first matches in Losers Round One. Start off with a Sui in the hill climb. We are now entering losers bracket round one. All of these racers are on their final race to get knocked out. Whoever ends up winning this bracket will go up against the winner of winners bracket for a grand final. These racers have a lot to lose, so they're going to be focused hard and working hard. Early lead by Danny Player One. This is a fairly straightforward course, only a few difficult turns. Exits with the speed advantage. Danny overtakes thanks to the rubber banding. Coming up on two subsequent tight turns. Danny has a little bit of trouble and ends up hitting the wall, but the guest ends up navigating it nicely. Rubber banding has taken effect and Danny is gaining some ground. Only a 45 meter difference between the two of them. It's still anyone's race. We're still in lap one. We'll just take a moment to thank Tokyo Attack for helping to put this on. We are live at the Games Done Quick venue in Herndon, Virginia. All of the racers you're seeing here are attendees of Games Done Quick. You can find them at twitch.tv/GamesDoneQuick, a charity for the Prevent Cancer Foundation. Jess has a little bit of a speed advantage and is in the lead right now, so. Coming up on our first tight turn of lap two. Danny navigates it well. The guest ends up having a little bit of trouble with it and he takes off. Danny with the speed advantage closing the gap. 15 meters, 13 meters, 9 meters, 8 meters. Partway through lap 2, it's still anyone's race.
test.
Yep.
All right, lost our mic for a second there. This has been our first snow track of the day. Didn't it look like he was going to take the early lead, but it looks like actually Rain of Soap is going to take over here. Now, Rain of Soap made it through his first round with a bye, a no-show competitor in our tournament. Zendek didn't have it so easy. He beat his competitor and he's here now. So Zendek took down Pear Strike in round two. Both of these racers testing their mettle. Going up against a snow track. I do not envy them. With that, Sir Zendek ends section one with a 20-meter lead. For a track like this with no traction, it's all about keeping that momentum through the turns. You're double penalized for hitting the walls, you're double penalized for losing your speed. Rain of Soap forcing its way through on the straightaway. So Stendek looking for his opening, and he finds it. Looking for his opening in section three. A 5-meter lead, still anyone's race. He's got the speed advantage, he just has to find the hole. Tight corner and Rain of Soap comes out with the speed advantage. Overtakes him. Looking like he's trying to keep his advantage however he can. This Zendek taking it casually, easy going, and he slips by. The Rain has a speed advantage right now. little bit of trouble on one of the turns, ended up putting himself to the wall, and now he's playing a catch-up game with Rain and Soap. The rubber banding. So Zendek has the speed advantage, coming back in. And Rain's pulling away. A close race with a lot of overtakes. With a last minute win by Reina Soap.
Yeah, that was like
that in round four, we're going to be seeing Konosumi going up against Reina Soten. Reina Soten played that match very well, but Konosumi has been tough to take. Nanagamari downhill. Back up against Mildew. Irish Joker versus Mildew in this next race. Irish Joker ended up taking his win with ease in the last round. Let's see if he can have quite the same time. Irish Joker taking an early lead in section one. Irish Joker's looking for his opening, trying to overtake. He had the speed advantage, and he has it now. Almost had in the turn, but Mildew boxed him out. Irish Joker looking for his opening. Is he gonna get it on the right? Is he gonna get it on the left? Mildew held him out, and away he goes. Two quick turns before we head back into a long series of straightaways. Coming out of this with a speed advantage would be huge. And Irish Joker has it. 15 feet, 20 meters, breaking away. meter difference entering section three with a series of hairpin turns. Still anyone's race. Mildew with a quick overtake. Irish Joker looking for his opening to get back in there. Irish Joker has a speed advantage, but he's having a hard time finding an opening. Irish Joker eyes the turn. Can he do it? And he does. Entering section four with a positional advantage and the speed advantage. This is Irish Joker's race to lose. At this point, all he has to do is hold off Mildew. These narrower lanes are going to pose quite a problem for Mildew trying to find his opening. But he finds it. Holy sh! Oh my god! At the last second! I literally don't know what to say about that. We're all standing around dumbfounded. No problem. You gotta be careful not to look away even for a moment during this tournament. Up next, we got Lord Mouse and Lightning. Back to Asui, a two-lap course. Heavy on the straightaway, short on the sharp turn. This one's going to be all about maintaining that momentum and boxing out your opponent. This can be a tough course to play at a high level. The lanes are wide. It makes it very difficult for you to keep your opponent at bay. Once again, take this opportunity to thank everyone for tuning in. We are live at the Games Done Quick venue in Herndon, Virginia for AGDQ 2017, a charity event for the Prevent Cancer Foundation. Feel free to check us out at twitch.tv/gamesdonequick, where you can see speedruns for the rest of this week up until Saturday. Lightning broke away, but Lord Mouse is catching back up. The name of this game is all going to be about boxing out your opponent. But with these wide lanes, it's going to be very difficult for anyone to maintain focus on the track while keeping your opponent behind you. The rubber banding is only going to make that doubly important. Swordmaster with a quick inside pass on that last turn, holding Lightning at bay and pulling away. He has the speed advantage. Just waiting for the rubber banding to kick back in. Both of these racers still in the winner's bracket. We're going to be moving on to loser's bracket round three next. Loser's bracket round two. I'm sorry, I misspoke. Coming up next will be Hikage versus Beacon. Lightning navigates that turn better and comes out with a speed advantage, but Lord Mouse coming in fast. Overtakes on the inside. Lightning doing his best to box him out on lap two. One course where it's not hard to take the lead, but it's extremely difficult to hold it. Coming up on the finish line, Lightning's coming in fast, but can't quite pull it off in the end. Lord Mouse takes it. Next up, our racers are going to be going head-to-head on Nago downhill. We got Meekin versus Hikage. Hikage knocked out in the last round by Lightning. Meekin taken down by... Oh, Meekin moving in. Getting knocked down to the loser's bracket by Naze. Here we go, our racers are ready at the starting line. Meekin looking like he's gonna hold the early lead. A few easygoing turns in section one. Easy opportunity for either of these racers to end up overtaking.
quite, Hikage can't quite pull it out. Because we are playing with no licenses. This gives everyone an opportunity to play on an even playing field, even those who haven't been in here practicing all week. These machines have been available to us since Monday. Deacon overtakes, but he puts himself to the wall, granting Hikage the speed advantage. Hikage has the lead, but can he hold it? Meekins pushing through. Meekins has the easy speed advantage right now. Hikage's coming in fast. One turn left to finish off Section 2 before we head into Section 3. It's a close race still. Just as I said, Hikage pushes through right at the last second for a 15-meter lead going into Section 3. Hikage keeps his speed advantage, pulling away. 50 meters, almost 60 meters ahead right now. There's still plenty of race to close this gap. Close this gap, Meekin is. Hikage does have the speed advantage and pulls back away in the last second. The rubber banding is starting to take effect. Like a slingshot, Meekin flies by Hikage. The narrow lanes are going to make it tough for Hikage to find his opening. Puts himself into the wall. Hikage takes the opportunity to pass him at the end. And at the end of Section 4 in sight, it looks like Hikage is our winner with a 20-meter difference.
The guest.
Both Tona and I are going to be commentating this one.
Upcoming is Nana Magari Hillclimb. So they're currently still selecting the cars.
Arthur again selecting the FD and Jeff with the Evo 10.
We'll be right back.
up. Can he do it in the second one? No, that was close. Trying to pop him out, but he is failing at it! He's desperate to try to overtake him again, but Guess just blocking him all the way. Mori lags spot right now, but there are many curves coming up. And Cruz almost managed to overtake Guess. But Guess just being able to block him up. Trying to overtake again on the straights, and he actually managed to do it. Arthur's getting further and further behind, but curves are coming up. I guess actually hit walls. This might be the chance for Arthur to come back in first place. He's trying to overtake. He's close to overtake, but he's being blocked off, I guess. And he managed to overtake! Guess tried to block him off but failed at it. Arthur ahead, getting through the fourth checkpoint. Both taking the curves very well. Guess is coming right up. Arthur trying to block him off. Will he succeed at it? Oh, that was close. He actually managed to block him off there.
Trying to take the lead from off.
And Arthur managed to get in first place. This was a good match. It was very close at the end. But Arthur managed to pull through. And I'd say he's getting the mic back.
Alright, so we've got Pear Strike versus Nozlu. Yeah, the Twitch account is Nozlu87. Challenge coming up right now. Tsukuba Snow, hill climb mode. Not only are both of these competitors going to have to deal with the difficult conditions of snow, but also going to have to deal with the difficult job of managing speed uphill. On manual transmission. Now, a big challenge these competitors are going to be facing is that every single mistake is going to be amplified threefold. First off, uphill is already difficult as it is. If you lose your momentum, you have to regain it, and it's very difficult to do so. But in addition to that, the snow provides no traction. This is going to be a very challenging match for our competitors. Both of these guys have done pretty well so far in the winner's bracket. Terrify pulling ahead, but not by much. This is still anyone's race. Neither of them have the speed advantage, and they're staying within 5 meters of each other. For a track like this, it's all about making sure you don't put yourself in the corner at any cost. Nozlu's coming in fast. Terrorstrike lost his lead, but he's looking to gain it back. He's navigating the turns with a lot more ease without Nozlu's breath on the back of his neck. Considering the conditions, these racers are racing at extremely high speed. One mistake can end it for either of these guys. Ozzy's trying to get by. He has the speed. He just has to find the hole. And at the last minute, entering Section 4, Nozlu overtakes Terrorstrike. One section remaining. This is still anyone's race. A 10-meter gap is nothing. Terrorstrike has the speed. Fancy overtake. Both racers seem too afraid to make any quick movements. Don't want to put themselves into the wall just to box out their opponent. This is the marathon match. But one mistake by Terrorstrike put him at a severe speed disadvantage. Turfstrike's actively closing the gap, but can he make it in time? Doesn't look like it. At the last second, with him still closing the gap, a 30-meter difference between the two of them, Nazlu wins it. You got it? This is going to start our winner's bracket round four. Konosumi versus Reina Soten. Konosumi's done pretty well in the winner's bracket so far, moving through competitors such as Naze, Ace of Spades. Reina Soten himself faced Sir Stendek and took it at the very end. Be an extremely impressive match. That we're ready for Chuchizaka. Takes the lead in sector one. Enter turn one. Reina Soten exits with a speed advantage, but Konosumi's coming back with a rubber bandage. Can he overtake right here? It doesn't look like it. Reina Soten's holding his lead. Reina Soten, well known for a much more direct, jerky movement with the wheel. I think one thing he's going to have to watch for is when he's boxing out an opponent, not putting himself in the wall. Tight turn, avoiding the oil. Konosumi slips a little bit and hits the corner, but he's okay. Rain has a speed advantage, trying to get by. He can't do it. He's getting boxed out. The wide lane, though, affords him the opportunity to get by. Thank you to Tokyo Attack for allowing us to put this on. Tokyo Attack's sponsor for Games Done Quick has generously provided all these arcade machines free of charge and has allowed us to take over the arcade room for one day to put on this tournament for you. Rain overtakes, but Konosumi takes it right back. Straight away here for Konosumi to trying to get the lead, but Rain is up, picking up big time with the rubber bandage. That 40-meter gap just turned into a 15-meter gap, which turned into a 5-meter gap. Rain of Soda is looking for his opening now to squeeze by. A series of quick turns. We're entering section four with literally no lead at all. This is anyone's race. Rain has the speed advantage and squeezes by in the last second. Can Kona pull it back in the last second? Racers determined to do their best. Kona maintaining his position. The ring has the speed. Can he slip by? And at the last second. And that's a win for Konosumi. Rain of Soda will be bumped down to loser's bracket. And we'll be seeing him pretty soon.
Up next, we'll be seeing Irish Joker versus
Lord Mouth. I hope you guys have been having as much fun as we are. You guys are having fun. Let me see some pog champs. Started right here in just a minute with Akina downhill. We got Irish Joker on the S2000 versus Lord Mouse in the Appraisal. Joker takes the lead right from the beginning, but just barely holding out Lord Mouse. Lord Mouse slips by, still in section one. With distinct speed advantage for Irish Joker, though, he can take it back at any moment if he can just find the opening. Lord Mouse exits that turn with a speed advantage. We'll be right back. Mouse overtakes Irish Joker. Coming up on the intersection 2 here. One last major turn. Can Irish Joker take it over? Not quite. Lord Mouse exits for the speed of Paris. Entering second 3. Irish Joker coming in fast. Is opening, overtakes Lord Mouse, and now he's trying to hold him off. Entering a quick series of 5 hairpin turns, Lord Mouse overtakes again. Lord Mouse in the lead, Irish Joker right behind. Lord Mouse seems to be exiting the turns with a little more speed, but Irish Joker, like a light, taking off right after each one. Finds his opening, but he finds on the outside of a hairpin turn. Lord Mouse keeps his advantage in section 4. This long series of straightaways here until the end of the track is going to test Lord Mouse whether or not he can hold on the Irish Joker and push his heart behind. Left, is there enough room left to pull it off? It's only a 5-meter difference. Lord Mouse pulls it out in the end. Losers round 3 going on right here. Sir Stendek and Takage, both of them trying to stay in this tournament. Starting off section 1, Syndek takes the early lead. A little bit of a speed advantage, able to pull away. But as soon as that rubber banding kicks in, Mikage's back in it. Navigating these turns like Breeze, want to make sure you don't lose any speed out of these corners. So Syndek goes a little bit into the gutter there to hold his tires. Mikage overtakes, but so Syndek takes it right back. Entering section two, it's still anyone's race. Syndek's in the lead with the speed advantage. Target's trying to find his opening and he finds it. Wide lane to the perfect opportunity for Syndek to get his spot back. We enter section three with Mikage still in the lead. Syndek's got all the speed, and now he's got the position. The speed advantage is gone. Can Mikage take it back? And he does. Both racers making use of the inside line. Syndek's trying to find his opening. He has the speed. He could do it. Plenty of time remaining in this race. Mikage's holding him back. Go ahead and let us know in the chat who you think is going to win this. And it looks like with the advantage, Mikage is going to win it.
What's up, guys? I'm Konosumi, and I'm going to be doing some more commentary since Arthur is in the seat at the moment. Let's see what car he selects. Oh, he's going with the R32, different from his previous choice of the FD. And Spade's going for the R34 GTR. They will be racing on Miyogi on the uphill. Yeah. Yoga. Three. Momentarily. Let's see who pulls out first in the lead.
Yeah. Oh, they're neck and neck right now. Arthur on the inside. It takes the lead. Let's stay right on him. Oh, Spade passes on the inside, overtaking Arthur on the straightaway. She's got her first hairpin. And Spade continues to get a lead over off. This is only section one, so anything can happen. We got Arthur getting some. Oh, but Spade hits a wall repeatedly, which gives Off the advantage, and he overtakes Spade in the corner. Off is doing a pretty good job of maintaining his lead at the moment. Let's see here. With Spade catching up rapidly, attempting to pass on the inside, but Spade constantly blocked by Off. But he makes his way in there and overtakes him during the corner. But Off is going for the inside pass once more, squeezing his way in there and passing. Alright. Got a hairpin coming up. Arthur is blocking Spades. Oh, but Spades goes on the outside, but he's getting some distance on Off, going for the inside pass. And it's not successful. Oh, Spades goes for the inside pass on that hairpin corner and overtakes Off. But Off is constantly going for the inside pass. And he's successful and overtakes Spades. We're on the final section of the course. With a couple of hairpins coming up, so anything can happen. Spade right on Off. Attempting to go for that pass. Oh, and Spade does it. Spade has overtaken Off on the straightaway, but we got one more hairpin to go. Oh, Spade has a bit of wacky movement there. Off barely gaining some distance on him. He's going for the inside pass. And he's successful. He did it. And the distance continues to increase between Off and Spade. And Off secures the win. Well done. The R32 is victorious.
still work into a loser round three. Alright, so Mildew has dropped out of the tournament due to not feeling very well. So with that, after this race, we're going to actually be moving back into the winner's bracket. So we got the Impreza versus the Fair Lady Z. This time we get to enjoy one of the downhill snow courses. Right from the start, Nosler gained a quick lead. Like I said before, you can see right there, it all takes is one little mistake going into the wall with a lot of speed. Lightning is keeping the lead right now, but Nas is coming in fast, closing the gap. With that, we end section one, heading into section two with Lightning in a very small lead. Nosler's staying right behind, waiting for his opportunity, waiting for Lightning to make one small mistake, that's all it takes. He has the speed, can he overtake? But Lightning exits that last turn with more speed. Nosler's coming in fast, but Lightning's boxing him out. Lightning needs to be careful not to put himself into the wall trying to do this. With Lightning's erratic movements, he has lost a lot of speed and allowed Nosler to take the lead. Lightning hops back out in front, but he's driving erratically. Extremely difficult course, but if there's one thing you gotta do, it's you gotta stay off the walls. These quick back and forth turns are forcing the racer to stay at extremely low speed. Section 4, and also needs to find his opportunity if he's going to pass up Lightning before the end of the course. Also has the speed. Can he overtake right here? And he can. Last minute, Lightning forces his way through. He gets the speed, but it's not quite enough to make the difference, and Lightning wins the round.
Now we have two of the organizers for this tournament, Lord Mouse and Konosumi, going head-to-head in winners round four. Nope, semifinals. My mistake. This is it, guys. This is what you've been waiting for. We're heading toward the end of this tournament. The best of the best is still in the winner's bracket. Transmission heading uphill in a keen of snow. Lord Mouse sees his opportunity and he seizes it. Anyone's race, Lord Mouse has the speed advantage, but he can't find an opening. And then he finds it. Commentator's curse, the moment I say something. With that, we end section one, heading into section two with no lead at all. Five quick uphill hairpin turns. Doing an amazing job holding their speed. Snow and uphill is a dangerous combination combined with these two very experienced racers. Lord Mouse dying for an opportunity to get by entering section three. It's still anyone's race. Kona has to know that any one of these turns can see the one that Lord Mouse overtakes him in. Lord Mouse overtakes him, Konosumi takes him right back. Hairpin turns, could this be it? Lord Mouse looking for his opening, he finds it. Some assume he wasn't quick enough to take it right back. Staying into section four of the end of the course. Kona behind, but they both have the speed. Kona takes it back. Still anyone's race. Lord Mouse trying to punch his way through. He's going to have to find that opening if he wants to win this. Lord Mouse loses a lot of speed exiting that last turn. He's going to have to find it again if he can't catch up to Konosumi before the end of this. That gap is closing. But in the end, Konosumi holds him off.
Hey guys, I'm back. Arthur is doing another race, so I will be providing commentary once more. I hope you guys can actually hear me this time. I'm getting pretty close to the mic and talking pretty loudly, so. So now it is Hikage versus Author Blue. And it appears it'll be Akagi with the hill climb. With I Need a Resolution by Marco as the song. The most important part of any race. And we will begin momentarily. Alright, here we go. It appears Author chose the Integra Type R as his car of choice. Again, a different selection from the previous. With Hikage in the FD. Oh, Author Blues with the overtake in the first corner. Getting some distance already on Hikage. That VTEC is totally kicking in right now. But Hikage appears to be gaining some distance on Author and closing the gap. Anything can happen in these first couple of quarters. Oh, looks like Hikage is going for the outside overtake, but was unsuccessful. During the second part of the track, Hikage is right on Author Blue's tail. And Author Blue is working hard to block Hikage from passing, but he ends up passing anyway. And takes the lead. We have some more hairpins coming up, which are great opportunities for the lead to change. Looks like Arthur Blues made an unfortunate fatal mistake, which gave Hikage a good distance over him. Looks like Arthur Blues is closing the gap on Hikage. Getting closer and closer by every turn. Oh, and Arthur Blues goes for the overtake and is successful. How will Hikage recover from this? Hikage is on the side of Azure Blues, but it's blocked once more. We're about to enter the fourth section of Akagi. The lead is constantly changing here, with Hikage in the lead over Azure Blues. Still pretty early into Section 4, so Author Blues does have a chance to take the lead once more, especially with rubber banding. Author Blues has managed to get right on Hikage's tail, approaching the final straightaway of Akagi, but makes a fatal error and hits the wall right before the finish. Well done.
Fox! Fox? Yes.
All right, now with that, we're moving on to our very last Losers Round 4 match. After this match, we'll be seeing Irish Joker versus Hikage, who just won against me. Rain of Soap versus whoever wins this round. In this race, we got Nace versus Lightning. This will wrap up Losers Round 4 right before we head into Losers Round 5 to finish off the Losers Bracket. Nace has the lead, but Lightning overtakes them. We enter Section 2 with literally no lead. This race is staying neck and neck. Lightning takes the inside corner a little too hard. Gives Nace the opportunity to keep the speed.
lead. Still anyone's race, we're in section three. Dante loses a lot of speed, but he ended up making it up. Right on Lightning's tail now. And he overtakes in the corner. He's pulling away. The gap is widening. Not even at section four yet. There's still plenty of time in this race. Don't count Lightning out. That we have the time extend entering section four. Nace loses a lot of speed and gets overtaken by Lightning. Lightning looking to hold this lead for the rest of the race. Wide lane should give Nace the opportunity he needs to overtake. He just has to get his speed up. And with that, Lightning progresses on into losers round five. All right, next up, we're gonna have Irish Joker versus Hikage.
Let's look it all around for you.
With this, we'll be seeing one of our competitors go on to be in the finals of the loser's bracket. We have Irish Joker versus Hikage. Rozaka starts off with a long straightaway before entering a long series of hairpin turns. Both racers racing on automatic transmission, much easier to race in a situation like this with automatic transmission. every single turn involves downshifting and upshifting, allowing the car to do that for you and focusing on the track. We'll see how much it helps our competitors. Tage has kept his lead so far, but all he needs is one mistake for Irish Joker to jump out in front of him. Irish Joker has the benefit of the rubber banding, so every single turn he's going to have a little extra power coming out of the turn. That's going to make a huge difference in his ability to keep up with it, Tage, even in the face of mistakes. Section 3 with Tage still in the lead, a 30-meter advantage. Whether our racers have any track knowledge, knowing the shortcuts and the secrets for this track might make a huge difference. For one of these competitors, this is going to be the end of the tournament. For the other, that's going to be going on to the finals of the loser's bracket. And ready to go up against Konosumi in the finals. Like Irish Joker is aware of the shortcuts. Tage, maybe not so much. With a 70-meter lead, hopefully Tage can hold it. Section 4 coming to a close. Tage has left the last hairpin turn. The rubber band is taking effect. Slingshotting Irish Joker forward, but it's not quite enough time. And with that, Tage goes on. Winner of this race will go on to race Tage, and the winner of that race going on to face Konosumi in the finals. Konosumi has yet to take a loss, so whoever goes up against him is going to have to beat him twice to win. Konosumi is only going to be required to win one race. With that, we're going to be moving on to Nanagamari with the hill climb. Reign with starting off this race with an earlier lead by Reign of Soden. Reign of Soden made the right call, Lightning overtook him, but only for a moment. Controlled his angle, controlled his speed, and he came out on top. And with that, Reign of Soden has already got a commanding almost 200-meter lead. This is easily the largest lead we've seen so far. Reign of Soden doing his best to keep his lead, but that rubber banding coming in full effect. Lightning coming up behind him. Entering Section 3, the two of them. Still a 40-meter lead. Make that 25. Lightning is caught back up and overtaken. Reign of Soden regaining his lead. Is there going to be enough time for Lightning to get it back? Lightning's falling further and further back, 50 meters. Excellent race by the two. And with that, we're going to have our final match in the loser's bracket. This is going to be Reign of Soden versus Hikage. I'm excited to bring it to you. We got the S13 versus the RX7 going into a Kena downhill. Like Hikage was going to get an early jump off the start, but Reign of Soden grabbed his lead.
taking off.
20, 25, 30. It's all.
These racers doing an excellent job controlling their speed in Akita downhill, but Reina Soto is barely pulling away. Now with Hikage with the speed boost. Two quick hairpin turns before we go into the rest of Akita downhill. And right then Hikage squeezes by. Narrow lanes are going to make it hard for Reina Soto to find his opening. One final turn in Section 2 before we head into Section 3 with the time extension. And it looks like we're going to be going into Section 3 with Hikage in the lead. Been playing a strong race over the course of this race. Even with the rubber banding in effect, he has managed to keep a commanding lead, a difficult thing to do with this system. But Hikage gets that extra little bit of power coming out of every turn and is able to overtake. With just a few extra turns left, we are heading into Section 4. Soto's close behind, and now he has a speed boost. Can he make use of it? This is his opportunity. It's now or never. Slingshotting past Hikage at this point would almost certainly secure the lead for him. What a risky maneuver in Section 4. Drops his speed significantly. He still has time. He still has the opportunity, but he needs to make it happen now. There isn't much time left. Hikage exits with the speed, with the speed advantage. And Hikage secures it. That'll be Hikage versus Kodasumi.
Oh no. Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, did I mess up?
No, you're right.
Why? Loser's bracket, I lost.
Oh, I'm sorry. Koda versus.
Oh, okay, I'm
wait,
sorry.
Wait, wait, what?
This is the one that you need to mark. And then sword mess.
Really?
Sorry about that. Sorry about that, we have our bracket straightened up. Alright, this will be Lord Mouse versus Hikage, and that will decide who goes on for the winner's finals.
we've got the Impreza versus the RX-7. Having a Tsubaki line uphill. Lord Mouse has been playing amazingly well over the course of this tournament, losing only to Kona Sumi, who has been an unstoppable force. But Hokage himself has secured many wins in the last few moments, so... Several overtakes, and we have Lord Mouse in the lead right now. Hikaki's right on his tail, looking for his opening. He has the speed advantage. Both racers take the inside line. But Lord Mouse loses too much speed, and Hikaki overtakes. Mouse almost with an overtake in the corner. And he gets it on that one. Midway through section two, we've already had a ton of overtakes. Can Lord Mouse hold his position? With the time extension, we're heading into section three. Hage has the speed, but he can't find the opening. Mouse is looking for his opening and takes it. Hikaki comes right back. Easy turn right here and the rubber band is going to take over. These long straightaways are a blessing in disguise for the Lord Mouse. Question is, does he want to be in the lead right now and give the rubber banding to Hikaki, or does he want to stay behind and try to pass him at the last moment? His only hope at this point is to box out Hikaki. Hikaki has the speed, but he can't find the opening. Hikaki is trying to punch through, and he does! This long straightaway, the rubber banding is taking over. Will it be enough to close this gap? And Hikaki wins it in the end. And Kona Sumi himself steps back into the winner's seat. This is a double elimination tournament, so Kona Sumi only has to win one race in order to win this. Hikaki has to win two in a row. The question is, can he do it? We'll be right back. could be it, guys. All it takes is one for Konosumi. Again, I want to remind everyone that we're coming to you from the arcade room in the Games Done Quick venue in Herndon, Virginia for Awesome Games Done Quick 2017, a charity event put on by the Games Done Quick LLC for Prevent Cancer Foundation. The machines have been provided to us courtesy of Tokyo Attack, who is sponsoring the event, free to play for all of us for the entire week. Shout out to Tokyo Attack for making this possible. Hikage takes the early lead. But Konosumi reverse boxes him out. I've never seen anyone put someone else into the wall like that. That move has got to be illegal. Doing a great job keeping his lead in section two. The rubber band is taking effect, but it seems to be having really no impact. Konosumi is holding a 50 meter lead, which is great. Konosumi came out of that turn with a little more speed, but the guy has got the power with him. With the rubber banding. Konosumi was with a remarkable lead right now. Let's see if he can hold on to it. Race. All Konosumi has to do is win this, and he is done. Konosumi's been consistently coming out of these turns with more speed, but one small mistake, and now Hikage has caught back up. But Konosumi, true to form, seems to be pulling away. Ah, but Hikage coming back. We enter section four. It's been a long tournament for both racers. The uphill climb is demanding. All Konosumi has to do is hold off Hikage for one more section. Hikage had the speed, but he didn't make use of it. Rubber band is taking effect, but is it going to be enough? The lanes are wide, the perfect opportunity for Hikage to come back. But with the finish line coming up, that's Konosumi winning the whole thing.
Yeah, I'm really happy about this. I'm very thankful that this tournament was able to be ran. Thank you to Games Done Quick and Tokyo Attack for letting us do this. I had a really great time. Had a lot of fun tonight.
One more time, I just want to give a shout out to Tokyo Attack for making all of these machines available to us free of charge, allowing us to record all of this audio and video straight off of the machines. They didn't have to do that.
That's it.
One more plug. We're going to be heading out pretty soon. Don't forget to check out twitch.tv/GamesDoneQuick. We're located at the Games Done Quick venue for AGDQ 2017 for the Prevent Cancer Foundation in Herndon, Virginia. We're so glad to have been able to do this for you. Thanks once again for Konosumi for helping to organize this, Lord Mouse for helping with technical issues, Sir Stendek for putting in so much work to make the stream really special, and thanks to all the racers for making this possible. We had a great time, and we really hope that you did too. And with that, I plan to not talk for another few hours.
Bye,
so, yeah, do we have any final words? I-